everyone and welcome back to This in Canada. My name is Japneet Kaur and I hope you're all healthy, happy and fine. This video is very important. Just like any other video where I tell you about colleges, universities, this video is very important because scam is on rise, especially during this time. So I want to make this video that could help you in order to avoid that situation which can cost you a lot of money or can leak your essential information to someone who can misuse it. So watch this video till end and let's start our video. Firstly, I want to tell you about a real story which happened with my friend, and I witnessed that incident because I was with her when it happened. And second, I want to tell you about types of scams which happen in Canada with international students. And at the end, I will tell you that how you can avoid falling for these scams as an international student. So this video is very important for international student. Don't miss this video because again this information is very important for you to know before coming to Canada, or even if you are already in Canada, it's very important for you to know about this information. So first let me share about the story which happened with my friend. So my friend applied for work permit. Actually, we both applied at the same time in February 2017. So we applied for work permit and everything was submitted. So one day we went to Gurdwara Sahib, and when we came back, and that was Sunday, I'm talking about Sunday, not any weekday. On Sunday, we went to Gurdwara Sahib. We came back to her apartment and at about 4 p.m., she got a call. So that person said that agent of CIC, he is working with CIC, which looks into all these documents for work permit, and he is the agent which is looking at her file. Feel how real it sounds because she submitted all the documents for work permit online, and at the same time she's getting a call from an agent who is saying that he works with CIC and he's going through her file. So he told everything about her file. Everything was correct. Whatever he told, he told that he told her correct date of birth. He told every information on her file correctly. So sounds that yes, that agent is working with CIC. When she was on call, I was with her, and it sounded so real because we think that who else will know about our information so correctly other than CIC, and she submitted her work permit just few weeks back. So she completed her master's in 1 year. So she was worried that she might get work permit for 1 year, right? And that person said, just listen to me, that person said that he's going through her file, he's accessing everything, and he knows that she completed her master's in 1 year. So he will give her work permit for 1 year unless he sends some documents to him and also pay extra fees to him. So that words were coming from that scammer, that agent who was saying that he works with CIC and he will give her 3 years of work permit even though she has completed master's in 1 year. Whatever information he gave was correct. Everything about her was correct, whatever he said to her. So you might have heard about different scam, but this scam looks so real. It looks so real. And the call she got was from an unknown number. There was no number displayed on it, nothing. It was just unknown number. And when she kept the phone, she obviously got so scared. She started crying because you know that getting 1 year work permit sometimes become difficult to get PR and everything. But that's different thing. She got so scared, she got so tense, and the person said that he will send some link and he has to upload those documents using that link and also pay some fees. She got so scared, and then we also got scared because we also have applied for work permit, and when you get these type of call, it's very scary. Going to become target of that scammer, but she was lucky because after 2-3 days she got her work permit, and she got her work permit for 3 years. So before that scammer sent out any link or anything, she got her work. So it's very important for you to learn about this information because she got lucky that she got her work permit within 2-3 days. But what if she wouldn't have got that work permit? What if that scammer would have sent out the link and she would have sent her documents, paid the fees and everything? What would have happened then? Because once your information is leaked, it's very difficult to retain everything back. So she was lucky, and I thank God that she was lucky with that. But I don't want this thing to happen with any of you guys, especially with international students. So what's the conclusion? If you get any call like this, that they are saying that you need to pay fees, you need to send some documents, they will give you a work permit for 3 years. Scammers can say that you can get PR in 6 months, you can get full-time job, anything, any scam like this. Do not respond to anything what they say. Do not send any money, especially do not send any personal information of yours. Even if it sounds so real that you have to believe that, what if you will not send any document? What if you will get 1 year of work permit? That's what my friend was thinking, that if she will not send document, what if she will get work permit of 1 year? And these things will happen. These things will flow into your brain. You have to avoid that. Firstly, if you are in that situation, what you can do is you can call and tell them you got this call and everything. They will verify. They will verify about everything. Don't send your documents. Don't send any money to anybody saying that they are agent from CIC, IRCC, CRA, anything. CRA is Canada Revenue Agency. What are the different types of scams you can face in Canada? First is the scam IRCC scam, like the one I told you earlier. A scammer in the form of agent from IRCC or CIC saying that they can give you 3 years of work permit if you will give them some money, some documents. Some scams would be like they will call you and say that your PR application is with us, but your PR application has this problem. If you send us some money, some documents, we can rectify those problems and we can give you PR in 3 months, 2 months. And third type of scam you can face over here is that IRC saying that we can give you a full-time job, very high paying job in Atlantic provinces or in Ontario, and then you can apply PR easily through that jobs. Nobody will give you any job unless you apply for that job. Don't fall for that scams. Second type of scam is through CRA, that is Canada Revenue Agency. So when you will come as an international student, you have to file your taxes as an international student, worker, permanent resident, like everybody who come to Canada has to file their taxes. So these scams are on so much rise. I think once in a week at least I get these calls. They will say that we are from CRA, you have done something wrong with your taxes, you haven't paid Canada the taxes you owe, or there's some trouble with your SIN number, that is social insurance number, and they will say that if you will not transfer money right away, there will be some police coming to your house and they will arrest you at the moment. So nobody knows about your taxes. And please don't tell any about your taxes, your tax information, your CRA account information, anything. Don't tell, don't share anything to anyone. So these calls are on. So the third type of scam, which is very common, which is not the phone call, which is actually message. So there are so many messages which I receive like twice, thrice in a week, that your account in this XYZ bank is inactive. In order to activate your account, click the link, and they will share a link with you. Or they will say that somebody send you money, in order to get that money, click this link. That bank is giving you some money as an incentive or something like bonus, click this link. Never click that link from your mobile, because as soon as you will click that link, your mobile will get virus, and then your all the personal information is, maybe you have a Wi-Fi account, maybe you have a hydro account, they will make it seem like your Wi-Fi company or your hydro company or any other bank is asking you for some money, or is saying that they owe you money and they are giving your money back to your account. You just have to click that link. Never click that link. And now the fourth type of scam is through email, and usually email like from Canada Post, Walmart, Amazon. These are so much on rise in Canada that they will say that you have Amazon account, you bought something but there is problem, click on the link. Or they will say that Walmart is giving $100 to these many people, click the link. Or Canada Post. And I can't stress upon how many emails are there in spam of Canada Post. You have received a parcel, click on the link. There's no parcel, there's nothing. That's scam. They will make you click the link. You can avoid by carefully looking at these messages, emails, phone calls. And the fifth type of scam, which you can't really avoid, is credit card scam. this happened with me as well. Somebody withdrew money from my credit card and it was written that it is withdrawn by Airbnb UK through PayPal. I didn't have any account on PayPal. I didn't have any account on Airbnb. And there was nothing which I could have avoided. Actually, I could have avoided and I will tell you just in a minute. But when that thing happened, right away I called my bank and they were able to detect that yeah, it is actually a fraud and I didn't do this type of transaction. So if this thing happened on your credit card, you don't have any liability because bank have that protection act and it is covered. So you don't have to pay anything back to the bank and they just send you a new credit card because now your credit card is being compromised because there is a fraud on your credit card. Nothing happened to your credit history, you don't have any liability. But if this thing happened to you, then first right away call your bank. But most importantly, you should see your transaction every other day or once in a week at least. Like for me, that transaction was still pending, so the bank was able to control that transaction. Firstly, call your bank and then explain them everything whatever happened to you, and then they will send you new credit card. And also what I did on my part is that I filed an online complaint because it's very important for the government to know that these type of frauds are increasing. But you can prevent this thing even before it can happen. And I didn't know about this and I feel like I should have known about this thing. And that's why I'm telling you and sharing my story with you guys. You can lock your credit card by yourself. You will have your online banking system or even web banking system. So there is option to lock your credit card. You can lock your credit card when you are not using it. So if you have locked your credit card, there can be no transaction. So if you lost your credit card, right, or somebody has stolen your credit card information, and if they are trying to put that credit card information or they are trying to do any purchase with your credit card, that transaction will not be allowed by bank because your card is locked. And at the end, I want to tell you how you can detect the call, email or message you are getting is a scam. So firstly, IRCC, Immigration CRA, that is Canada Revenue Agency, will never call you. They send you email and even in the email, they will never tell you what they are looking for. For example, IRCC wants some document from you. They will never write in the email that please provide this document. They will only tell you that there is a message for your account. So you will have a CIC login, right? You will have a CRA login. So they will only tell you that there is a message in your CIC login account or your CRA login account. You have to go to your account, login with your username, password, and then you will find there is an update on your application or anything. And now it's important, now it's your duty and responsibility to never share your login ID and password with anyone. Keep it secure, keep it with yourself and don't share with anyone. Second important point, never give your SIN, that is SIN number, that is social insurance number, to anyone. If somebody asks you your SIN number over phone, don't give it. Never ever give it. Your SIN number is the number which contain all your information, which contain information about your family, your taxes, your employment, everything you have done in Canada is on that SIN number. Keep that SIN number very secure. It's just an A4 size page, but it contains all the useful information. The only providers which ask you your SIN number are bank when you're opening an account. Second, your employer will ask you your SIN number. So make sure never ever to give your SIN number to anybody. And then the third thing is that IRCC will never ask you for money in exchange for 3 years of work permit or ECPR or a full-time job. IRCC only want the fees they need and you have to pay that fees. But they will not call you and ask that if you give them $4,000, then you can have 3 years of work permit, which happened with my friend, right? Never ever transfer money through wire or PayPal if somebody on the phone is asking you to do that. And the third thing is that if you are waiting for your study permit or if you are applying for your study permit or if you are applying for colleges, colleges will never call you. But they will never call you. They can email you or they can tell you via the online portal. And at the end, I would say that if you encounter any of these suspicious activities, or your account is being compromised, or you get these scam calls and you are not sure that whether they are scam or not, don't act on them. Just call the IRCC or CRA. Like this video, consider subscribing. It will mean universe to me. And like this video and do comment if you have faced any other scam like this, so that other people and other upcoming students know about that. And I will see you in another video. Till then, take care, be aware, and always keep your information safe and secure. Best of luck and goodbye.